and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. In today's video, we are going to understand about Michelson interferometer. The main aim of this kit to determine the wavelength of a monochromatic light source by using a Michelson interferometer. Interferometers are used to precisely measure the wavelength of a optical beam or index of a refraction of air or any other glass plates through the interference fringes pattern. The Michelson interferometer is the best example of what is called an amplitude splitting interferometer. It was invented in 1893 by Albert Michelson. With an optical interferometer, one can measure distance in terms of wavelength of light used by counting the interference fringes that move when one or the other mirror is moved. So we are going to perform the same experiment that Albert Michelson performed and get the wavelength. We will find the wavelength of the monochromatic light source which we are provided with this kit. So this is our kit of Michelson interferometer. The order code for this kit is 1920-4401.7. So these are the main kit and the accessories which are provided with this kit. We will start with the monochromatic light source, or this is the diode LED source which is powered by with this IC regulated source. So this is the power of this LED light which will be used in the experiment. This is the screen and the stand as well with this. So the fringes pattern will be observed at this screen, and this is the basic system of this screen. And we are also providing a user manual to better explanation of this experiment and to get the proper records or proper calculation with this kit by using this Michelson interferometer kit. So now we move on to the description of this interferometer kit. So first we open this plastic case carefully so the case will not break. Now I will explain to you the different items of this kit. There are two mirrors which are in a 90 degree angle placed. This is the adjustable mirror and this is the movable mirror. There is also a micrometer connected with this. The description of micrometer least counts will be explained soon. So, and this is the beam splitter which splits the monochromatic lights in two waves. The 50% will goes to this mirror, and the 50% will after reflection will go to this mirror. And this is the compensating plate which will be provided for white light sources, which when we use the white light sources, the compensating plate is required because of the phase difference. Due to the phase difference which is higher in the white color sources, so that will be used when the compensating plate is required. Also we use this coinciding lens to expand the fringes when we get the fringes directly to the screen. क्या नहीं आया मतलब
रिकॉर्डिंग नहीं हुई
क्यों नहीं हुई
क्या बोला
सो देर आर टू मिरर्स इन दिस किट द M1 इज द फिक्स मिरर विच कैन बी एडजस्टेड बाय दिस स्क्रू माउंटेड बिहाइंड दिस मिरर एंड दिस इज द M2 मिरर विच इज द मूवेबल मिरर एंड इट इज प्लेस्ड ऑन अ कैरेज द कैरेज कैन बी मूव्ड विद दिस माइक्रोमीटर द मिरर इजिली मूव्ड विद दिस सो द कैरेज हैज अ कोर्स एंड फाइन बैक एंड फोर्थ मूवमेंट During the motion, M2 remains exactly parallel to its preceding position. So when we move this mirror, the first position which is at the mirror, assume this mirror at this position, and we will move this mirror in a forward or backward movement, the mirror remains exactly the same where it was. So this is the movement of this mirror. Now we will explain the micrometers. There are two micrometers. This is the coarse travel micrometer and this is the fine travel micrometer. The coarse travel micrometer the one turn of this micrometer displaces the mirror by 1 millimeter. As we move this micrometer one turn, the mirror moves only 1 mm, and the fine travel of the drum, that one turn of this fine travel micrometer displaces the mirror by 0.025 mm. So that is the division of the micrometer is equivalent to 0.0005 mm, which is the very least count of this proper system, and which will be make easier to movement of the mirror, very slight movement, and we will get the fringes, because the fringes will be very smaller and we need very small movement to observe the fringes pattern. So now we will start constructing the Michelson interferometer properly with this kit. For this we will first use this IC regulated power supply for the power source. It will be easily connected to any power source of 220 volt AC, and which will be on and off with this on off switch. The positive and negative of this monochromatic light will be connected here and power on. Now properly place this LED so that the beam of this LED will directly intercept at the center of this movable mirror. So we will try to place it at center. So this is the center. So this is the center. Now we do not move the light source throughout the experiment. The light source remain at the constant position from this side. So now we put this light through this mirror, and we make sure the reflection of this light directly incident to the light source. So for this we move this screw, adjustment screw of this mirror, and you will see the light source reflection moving to the source directly incident. You can see the reflection is here, sorry, right now. And we move this, try to move the reflection of this light source directly into the mirror. So this is the straight going to the parallel to the light. So we place this screen at which will we get the observe the fringes pattern. So here we will see the two points, which are one from the incident or one from the reflection of this mirror M2 and M1, which is the fixed mirror, and the other from the beam splitters output. So we slightly move this beam splitter so that both the point coincide together exactly like this. So this is now the 45 degree angle between the optical path of this mirror and to this mirror. So the both the point coincide together. Now at this point the setup of the interferometer has been done. Now we will expand this point or this fringes pattern of optical rays by using this collimatic lens. So this lens can easily be removed with this plate and can easily placed in front of this LED source. So the lens can be easily tightened to this light source, and the collimating lens is working it. Now we will see the fringes pattern, which is shown at the observation screen or the output screen. For this we will have to dim the light surrounding here. Now as we can see, there are fringes pattern over the bright screen, white colored screen. So these fringes can be changed to lighter to darker by moving this fine cross micrometer. You can see closely, very carefully. The image is not proper in the recording session, but you can, when you use the practical and do the practical, you will see the clear by your eyes, because the image quality or video quality from the recording sessions are not at proper as we can see by the human eye. So for measuring the wavelength, just note down the reading of micrometer, fine travel micrometer, which is given in the formula. And mark any point on the screen, and by moving the micrometer, count how many fringes are passed through this point. Like we select any point, or we can select the center point from the fringes pattern, and we will count now. That is right now 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 so now we will count, first count 50 fringes, then count 100 fringes, then count 200 fringes. So and by counting the fringes, we will measure the micrometer reading before counting and after counting, how much the reading displays. So this will be give the displacement of this movable mirror. So now when counting the fringes, first take down the reading of this micrometer and in the observation table here, which is provided in the manual. Then initial position reading, then counting the number of fringes, write down it here, and the final position after counting the fringes, which is 50, 60 or whatever you count. Then put the values in this formula. This is the D, or this is the lambda 2D, the D difference between the distance moved from initial final positions minus initial position, you will get the D, and number of fringes N will be what you count from the fringes pattern, and you will get the wavelength by this formula. So that's how you use the Michelson interferometer for calculating the wavelength of any monochromatic light. So for using the compensating plate, this glass plate can easily be placed here in this machine or in this kit, and the spacer of 45 degrees already provided at this. This can be foldable or you will be easily removable with the screws. So when we use the white light source or when we do the compensating plate practical, we can use the compensating plate when the phase difference of the light source or incident rays are different. So that's how we use the Michelson interferometer, and this is from the Tesca. For any queries, please refer to the manual, and you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.